Warning. This experiment handles fuming nitric acid. Use vinyl gloves when working with it. Do not use nitrile gloves. This experiment uses sulfur dioxide and handles isopropyl nitrite. This experiment must be performed outside or in a fume hood. Greetings, fellow nerds. This is another Lab Notes video where I research procedures I don't have experience with. What this means is that I will stumble around and mix up haphazardly, and whatever I find, I'll pretend that's exactly what I was trying to do. So my objective was to make sodium nitrite. It's different from the more commonly available sodium nitrate in that it has one less oxygen atom. I want sodium nitrite to produce various metal complexes. Unfortunately, nitrite isn't very stable under a lot of conditions, so it's notoriously difficult to synthesize for the amateur. Unfortunately, that includes me. I'll tell you up front that I failed in my attempt. But I did test a number of interesting and useful reactions, so it's not a total failure. I must emphasize this is not a full procedure. It's just my lab notes on what I've done and failed to do. Normally, amateurs make sodium nitrite by reacting sodium nitrate with a metal powder like copper or lead at high temperatures. But since that uses high temperatures, I want to try something totally crazy and go for a mild temperature method of making nitrosylsulfuric acid, then isopropyl nitrite, and finally somehow break that down into sodium nitrite. So what did I attempt and how did I fail? So first I had to make the nitrosylsulfuric acid. I started with 200 grams of fuming nitric acid. It had to be fuming nitric acid and not azeotropic acid for reasons I'll explain later. But there can't be any water in it. I have a video on how to purify nitric acid into fuming nitric acid if you need it. Anyway, then I set up a sulfur dioxide generator consisting of 300 grams of sodium metabisulfite along with 250 milliliters of water. Up here I had a pressure equalized dripping funnel with a total of 400 milliliters of 3% hydrochloric acid. Now I didn't actually have a dripping funnel that large, so this one only contains about 150 milliliters, but I just refilled it as I went along. Anyway, the gas was led into the fuming nitric acid with a glass pipette since the plastic tube would get destroyed by the acid. The nitric acid is cooled with an ice bath to 0 Celsius, and the hydrochloric acid is dripped into the sulfur dioxide generator slowly. I'm going at about 1 drop per second and I'm adding the acid over the course of 2 hours. I'm also slightly warming the sulfur dioxide generator on the hot plate to about 75 Celsius to drive out the sulfur dioxide. So what's happening? The sulfur dioxide is reacting with the fuming nitric acid to produce nitrosylsulfuric acid which precipitates out. For those of you familiar with the lead chamber process of making sulfuric acid, you probably know that it's made by reacting sulfur dioxide with nitric acid. This is a well-known reaction and I and many other YouTubers have already done it, like Cody's lab. So if that produces sulfuric acid, how am I producing nitrosylsulfuric acid? To answer that, we must realize that while this reaction is what is quoted for making sulfuric acid, it's actually a great deal more complex and proceeds through a few steps. We can see that at first nitrosylsulfuric acid is produced from sulfur dioxide and nitric acid and then subsequently decomposed by water or nitrous acid. If we can somehow block these reactions, we can stop the progress and trap the nitrosylsulfuric acid. We stop the hydrolysis reaction by simply using fuming nitric acid which has no water, and we stop the nitrous degradation step with cold temperature. And that's why I'm freezing the reaction. Granted though, it's not perfect. Some of the nitrosylsulfuric acid will still decompose, but hopefully we'll get enough to use. Okay, so I added all the hydrochloric acid and the sulfur dioxide generator is steadily producing gas. For the first 3 hours I kept changing the ice, but I'll be honest, I got lazy and let it go overnight. And here we are the next day, and we can see a rather large amount of nitrosylsulfuric acid crystals. I'll be honest, I was actually surprised just how well it worked. I was only expecting maybe 20% yield, but this seems like most of it. In fact, it was so much that I couldn't pour it out properly. I had to wash it out using some glacial acetic acid. I poured it out and vacuum filtered it. And there it is, nitrosylsulfuric acid. It's not stable and will decompose as it absorbs moisture from the air, so we'll need to use it quickly. It's an extremely powerful nitrosylating agent, and if you really want to save it for the long term, you would dissolve it in concentrated sulfuric acid. I'm just going to use it all now, so I got 500 milliliters of cold isopropyl alcohol I had chilled in the freezer and added the nitrosylsulfuric acid to it. I used an ice bath to keep it cold and I have a thermometer in the alcohol to monitor the temperature. If it goes above 5 degrees Celsius, I stop adding and wait for it to cool down. What's happening is the nitrosylsulfuric acid is reacting with the isopropanol to produce isopropyl nitrite and sulfuric acid. Unfortunately, the reagents and products aren't very stable and tend to decompose, so the cold temperature is needed to help stabilize them. The plumes of brown gas is the nitrogen dioxide being generated from the decomposition of nitrosylsulfuric acid and isopropyl nitrite. Once it was all added, I mixed the isopropanol with an equal volume of ice water. The isopropyl nitrite phase separated and we can see it here as this yellow layer. I used the separatory funnel to separate the layer of isopropyl nitrite from the sulfuric acid, isopropyl alcohol, and water. And here is our isopropyl nitrite. If you want to store this, you can do so over sodium carbonate to stabilize it, but it does decompose with time. Now I personally need sodium nitrite, so I want to somehow break down the isopropyl nitrite. Unfortunately, this is where I failed. Miserably. I got 300 milliliters of methanol and added to it 120 grams of sodium hydroxide. I stirred until dissolved and chilled it on an ice bath. Then I added my isopropyl nitrite to try and precipitate the sodium nitrite. At least that was the idea. I was hoping the strongly caustic sodium hydroxide would decompose the isopropyl nitrite into isopropyl alcohol and sodium nitrite. Sodium nitrite has low solubility in methanol, so I was hoping this would give me pure sodium nitrite. Instead, what happened was the isopropyl nitrite just decomposed into sludge. So that was a total failure. I'm sure all of you organic chemists familiar with alkyl nitrate chemistry are laughing your asses off at me. You might be asking why I didn't just try to add the nitrosylsulfuric acid to aqueous sodium hydroxide and produce sodium nitrite and sodium sulfate that way. I did, but it decomposed far too quickly. And the applications I want the sodium nitrate for demand at least technical grade purity. So that's why I tried the isopropyl nitrate route, which failed. So overall, this has been one long failure. I guess I'll just have to use one of the high temperature methods to make sodium nitrite. At least I have a way of making alkyl nitrates without using sodium nitrite, but that's kind of useless to me right now. Do you guys want me to make a formal procedure video on making isopropyl nitrite, or are these lab notes enough? I'm not sure if there's any demand for isopropyl nitrite. Anyway, those are my lab notes for this week. I'm going to put this project on hold and come back to it later. Thanks for watching. Special thank you to all of my supporters on Patreon for making these science videos possible with their donations and their direction. If you're not currently a patron but would like to support the continued production of science videos like this one, then check out my Patreon page here or in the video description. I really appreciate any and all support.